All right. All right. Let's take care, make sure we're well equipped, and hit the road. Tier garbage stuff. No real improvement there. Except a different kind of damage. Wow. That is a hilarious looking hat. I'll actually put that on the tank. For the ditch. Okay. So, okay. What? Same tier, good enough. Yeah, well, that looks good. vendor going away.
If there's anything I can do for you, please, please tell me. I'm sure.
This interface. Stupidest thing ever. Okay, how do I give it to them? Can't show us again.
Just leave me alone, Warden. Seriously. Upset. Did you want to talk about something? You want to be a berserker? Thought I'd never see the day. No, see, it's funny because you'll never be able to do it. A mage wants to be a berserker? But if you know someone fit for this type of work, I'll teach him. It'll be nice to have another berserker to grunt at for a change. What? You don't see me waist-deep in entrails every time I sodding step up to fight? I'll teach your warriors to be the best berserkers on the bleeding surface. What the sod is there to know? You get mad, you fly into battle, and things die. It's pretty simple. The hard part is getting in touch with your rage. We all learn to hold that back. It's why we don't kill every duster who looks at us sideways. You need to shut that off. For some people, being in battle is enough. But others have to think about something. Violence, monsters, nobles, your wife, whatever. I, especially my wife. Well, for most berserkers, it does. Several years ago, I worked with a berserker on one expedition. He just couldn't work himself up. We had to kick him in the stones before he could get going. Why not? When you fight, you get mad. By the stone, it's a sodding tactic to enrage your enemy so he makes a mistake, right? Berserkers grab that anger and drink it like it's yesterday's ale. Then we turn it against our foes and watch the limbs fly. Well, for most berserkers, it does. Several years ago, I worked with a berserker on one expedition. Just couldn't work himself up. We had to kick him in the stones before he could get going. You saw it. Tell that thing to give it back. That dog, mangy mongrel, sodding thing.
Don't
took
rub
my
it
pants.
In.
I'll show him. Yeah, I don't need my pants anyway. But the dog doesn't know that. It will be his sodding downfall. You hear that, Nug Humper? I'm coming for you. Prepare to die. Hey, Warden, you gotta hear this one. This human walks into a tavern, and there's an elf there. And she says... she says... she says, I don't... I've been watching you. Where can I get some sauce for that rump roast? That's right. You've wiped your foot on the Ogryn doormat of love. Go and make yourself ready, woman. I'll be right there to see to it.
Okay, now can I?
What the hell?
What do you wish of me? If you must. By others, do you mean yourself? Then I shall teach you what I can. What do you wish of me?
Alright, onward to...
Indeed.
Indeed.
Let's see... So where the fuck? Okay, return to... Redcliffe.
Indeed.
Indeed.
But forward.
I understand you've acquired all the allies you could.
That's good. We can call the lands meet if you are ready. I would prefer not giving Loghain time to consider, but it is up to you. I do not wish to go to Denerim unless you are with me.
That's you.
Excellent. I shall make the arrangements. Let us be off to Denerim, and may the Maker watch over us. Denerim is the heart and soul of Ferelden. It was the city of King Callenhad, the birthplace of Andraste. As stubborn as a Mabari, and as good to have on your side. If we defeat Loghain here, the rest of the nation will follow us. By calling the Landsmeet, I've struck the first blow. The advantage, for the moment, is ours. He will have little choice but to show himself, to oppose us directly. He will strike back at us. The only question that remains is how soon. Loghain, this is an honor, but the Regent would find time to greet me personally.
How could I not welcome a man so important as to call every lord in Ferelden away from his estates, while a blight claws at our land?
The blight is why I'm here. With Caelan dead, Ferelden must have a king to lead it against the Darkspawn.
Ferelden has a strong leader. Its queen. And I lead her armies. And who is this, Ingrid? Some new stray you picked up on the road? And here I thought it was only royal bastards you played the nursemaid to. You have my sympathies on what happened to your order. It is unfortunate
I'm
that they chose to turn against Ferelden.
Screw that guy.
Don't interrupt, Churl. Your betters are talking.
Enough, Kalthjin. This is not the time or place. I had hoped to talk you down from this rash course, Eamon. Our people are frightened. Our king is dead. Our land is under siege. We must be united now if we are to endure this crisis. Your own sister, Queen Rowan, fought tirelessly to see Ferelden restored. But do you see her work destroyed? You divide our nation and weaken our efforts against the Blight. Your selfish ambitions to the throne. Caelan depended on the Grey Warden's prowess against the Darkspawn, and look how well that ended. Let us speak of reality rather than tall tales. Stories will not save us.
I cannot forgive what you've done, Loghain. Perhaps the Maker can, but not I. Our people deserve a king of the Theron bloodline. Alistair will be the one to lead us to victory in this blight.
The Emperor of Orlais thought I could not bring him down.
No.
Expect no more mercy than I showed him. There is nothing I would not do for my homeland.
Well, that was bracing. I didn't expect Loghain to show himself quite so soon. Calling the Landsmeet is only the start. Now we must ensure that every noble there sees Loghain's duplicity. We have no small task ahead of us. We need eyes and ears in the city. Loghain has been here for months. The roots of all his schemes must begin here. The sooner we find them, the better we can turn them to our advantage. Go have a look around, and see what you can turn up. Better yet, find the nobles who have arrived for the Landsmeet. Test the waters. See how many will support us. When you're ready to talk strategy, come upstairs to my sitting room. We can lay out our plans for the Landsmeet then.
Wait. Standard bearer, wait. Oh, okay. Meet. Let's go.
Indeed. Lay your hand on me once more, dwarf, and the moment shall be your last.
Don't take it personally. I stepped on a rock. You don't want me to fall and break my neck, do you?
The prospect would not trouble me overmuch.
You sound just like Veronica.
Then I commend her good sense. But this is the last time I will tell you. Touch me no more.
Veronica said that, too.
Wow. Okay, where the hell do I go for that? Oh, hey. I got quests.
Take this. You've earned it.
Nice to see you again. Really? Oh, pardon my incredulity. I would like to examine them in any event. Let me see. Are old, no question, and the script. It's written in cipher. Early believers used them to keep their writing safe from the Devinter Magus. These could be authentic. Please, let me examine it. I need parchment, quill, and ink. What was the trick to the cipher again? I examined your scrolls. I know a few of the early Chantry ciphers, but I'm not fully familiar with this one. The bits I have made out. This may be an account of Mafferath's final days, and perhaps more. I know it's remarkable. The same Mafferath who betrayed our prophet and saw her burn alive in Minrath Rus. If we could get a real translation, well, it could be the find of our lifetime. Could take months. The ciphers were designed to be difficult for the magisters to decrypt. Who knows what secrets we can uncover, what truths we can find. Here is all of the allowance I have for acquisitions. Take it and go. A thousand blessings.
Can I get you a letter so you can get off my back?
What am I supposed to do with the dump site?
Magic exists for spells, man.
Let's see here. Yeah, that's not important. And the chances, Lord. Off the market district in Denver. Looks like that's something. Aha, straight south.
Be careful with that package, you know. It's worth more than your life.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts. Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
Dwarven craft. Find dwarven craft.
Got it.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
I'll get on it.
How the hell?
Dwarven crafts.
Oh, shut
find
up.
Dwarven crafts.
Maybe I can go through some of this.
What? You found Flemeth's grimoire? Ever since we discovered the condition of the Mage's Tower, I had wondered if it might be recoverable. But I had yet to speak of it to you. How fortunate that you found it on your own. You have my thanks. I will begin study of the tome immediately. Secrets. My mother has many of them, and this tome represents the one time that they were able to get away from her. I do not intend to squander this opportunity to learn more than Flemeth wished me to know. This should be interesting.
Oh, Alistair.
A fine gift. You have my thanks.
Oh, how dear of you. Thank you so much.
Still acquired. Yeah, whatever.
Hmm.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
Can I get you a ladder so you can get off my back?
I haven't really explored here.
This is a nice change from having to sleep in the woods, isn't it? Yes? Denerim is Feraldin's most important city, yes? This is the seat of power, the jewel in the crown of the king. She is Feraldin's heart. Her walls are strong, but within them lies so much beauty. Just like the country and the people.
Aha, here we go.
Is that for me? Really? Wow,
I'm blah, 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 blah.
I hope all the accommodations are to your liking, Warden. Please let me know who's troubling you.
What you need? Aye, all right then.
All right, all right.
I gotta tell you before it make it through that pointy skull. Bank the coals at night, or the stew don't cook. Dinner's not ready yet, and don't ask. It'll be served when it's done, and that's that. Now, shoo, out of my kitchen.
Can't talk now, sir. Mistress Agatha would have my hide.
We had a whole wagon load of potatoes, so rotten.
Maids and servants. Look at that.
Excuse me, I have to dust the Earl's sitting room. No, I'm from Redcliffe. Lady Isolde brought me here to be her chambermaid last spring. I've family here, though. I beg your pardon, sir, but I really can't be seen standing about. The housekeeper will have my head. Good day.
Servant asks if I would like a change of clothes, I will set the house on fire.
I await your command. At times, perhaps. A world full of people and buildings and things was all very foreign to me. If I wished companionship, I ran with the wolves and flew with the birds. If I spoke, 'twas to the trees. Don't be foolish. I recall the first time I crept beyond the edge of the wilds. I did so in animal form, remaining in the shadows and watching these strange townsfolk from afar. I happened upon a noblewoman by her carriage, adorned in sparkling garments the likes of which I had never before seen. I was dazzled. This, to me, seemed what true wealth and beauty must be. I snuck up behind her and stole a hand mirror from the carriage. It was encrusted in gold and crystalline gemstones, and I hugged it to my chest with delight as I sped back to the wilds. Flemeth was furious with me. I was a child and had not yet come into my full power, and I had risked discovery for the sake of a pretty bauble. To teach me a lesson, Flemeth took the mirror and smashed it upon the ground. I was heartbroken. And a foolish one. Flemeth was right to break me of my fascination. Beauty and love are fleeting and have no meaning. Survival has meaning. Power has meaning. Without those lessons, I would not be here today, as difficult as they might have been. They did indeed. To return to your original question, perhaps my time in the wilds was indeed lonely, but such was how it had to be. I find myself at times wondering what might have become of the girl with the beautiful golden mirror, but such fantasies have no place in its reality.
I'll get on it.
Chetties.
Ah, Warden, here we go. I trust you've made yourself comfortable. Good, because it's likely to be your last rest for a while. This is Alina, she's...
I am Queen Honora's handmaiden. She sent me here to ask for your help.
Or perhaps the young lady prefers to speak for herself.
The Queen... She's in a difficult position. She loved her husband, no? And trusted her father to protect him. When he returns with no king and only dark rumors, what is she to think? She worries, no? But when she tries to speak with him, he does not answer. He tells her not to trouble herself. So she goes to help. A visit from the Queen to the new Isle of Denon is only a matter of courtesy, and she demands answers. They now know she is a threat to her father's power. I think her life is in danger. I heard Hal say she would be a greater ally dead than alive, especially if her death could be blamed on Arl Eamon.
We may have no choice but to trust Honora. The Queen is well-loved. If Loghain succeeded in pinning her death on me, I'm not sure that's a risk we can afford to take.
I have some uniforms. Earl Howard has so many new gowns every day. A few more will not cause much stir. I will show you to the servants' entrance. We must slip in and out with my queen before anyone is the wiser. I will go ahead to House Estate. Meet me there as soon as you can.
I'm glad you decided to help. With Honora's knowledge, we have a far better chance against Loghain.
How's the state? Okay.
She's obviously more than a maidservant, but I imagine it's useful for Honora to have a trusted attendant who can move more freely than she herself. And consider what aid she and the Queen might be to us. If Honora has truly turned against her father, she becomes the one thing we lack. Someone with a true understanding of Loghain's plans and allies. With her guidance, we can form a far more successful strategy against him.
easily than without you there. There will be none to see it, save those who are already loyal to Loghain. And given your reputation, Warden, I think Loghain knows it's safer to carry out his plots far from where you could disrupt them. She and Talyn were promised as children and practically raised together. She was a smart child. Knew how to listen, and how to blink those big blue eyes and get anything she wanted. Her mother's looks, her father's brains, and the best tutoring Merrick's money could buy. It's a potent combination. From Alina's story, he turned against her first. If he truly intends to sacrifice her, I think it will be strong motivation to break the parental bonds. In any event, I would far rather have the opportunity to ask such things of her than simply hear about her murder. If Honora speaks out against Loghain, hers would indeed be one of the most powerful voices of the Landsmeet. As you like. My palace is your palace.
Good.
All right, all right. Can't walk around a small puddle, really? All right, all right.
kind of roundabout way.
The servant's entrance is on the other side of the house. We must slip past this crowd to reach it. We will have to be very careful on how he's inside. Do you not see the angry workmen there? I think it will be some time before even Random Rao can use this front door, no? I will be right behind you.
No, not this crowd.
Where am I going?
Distract the guards, but you must move quickly. More guards patrol every hour. If they find these two missing, they will know... How you say... Something is amiss. Hurry! My lady does not have much time. Are you all prepared? I will go distract the guards. These two know who is allowed to come and go. They will not be fooled. But the uniform should work on most of those inside. I will lure them into the courtyard. Wait in the bushes.
All right.
Well, that answers that.
Paul finds what you have done. You must be careful now. The servants, they will not look closely at anyone in uniform. All guards are alike to a cook, no? But you should not draw attention to yourself. Most of the guards are new. They will not know you for a stranger at a glance. It is best to keep your distance from all of them and try to blend in. She's in a guest room, off the main hall. Andra, stay guide us.
Probably roasting the elves.
You're bluffing. Is that corner or something? Are you playing cards or chit chat?
What is it? My warden is here, my lady.
Thank the Maker. I would greet you properly, but I'm afraid we've had a setback. My host was not content with leaving me under heavy guard. He sealed the door by magic.
I did not know. There were only guards here when I left. We must get her out of there.
Don't panic, Erlina. Find the mage who cast the spell. He'll most likely be at house side. Well, if he didn't know you were here, he soon will.
Please, Walden, I beg you, do not leave my queen here.
Free me, and I promise you my aid in the Landsmeet.
We do not have much time. We must go before the guards discover us. Theron Howe will probably be in his rooms. They're at the end of the hall, on the left.
Who goes there?
I thank you for creating such distraction, stranger. I have been waiting days for the opportunity. You never hear music in the sound of a key turning in a lock until you've been imprisoned. Perhaps introductions are in order, if only so you never call me that again. I am Riordan, Senior Grey Warden of Jada, and you must be Duncan's last recruit. Yes, you match his description. With an offer of hospitality and a poison chalice. I was fool enough to think Loghain didn't yet know who I was. I saw him go into the dungeons. He may still be there. For the most part, attempting to hold my tongue. I was sent when we received no word from King Kaelin
As to the outcome at Ostagar, the king had invited all the wardens of Orlais and their support troops to join him. Then nothing. We had 200 wardens and 24 divisions of cavalry. The first we heard of Loghain's edict was when everyone was turned back at the border. That was when the rumor reached us that wardens were being blamed for the massacre. We finally decided it was safest to send someone alone to learn how best to fight the Blight and this regime simultaneously. As a native Ferelden, I volunteered to make the crossing. I wouldn't be much use to you in my current condition. And if you'll pardon me, I've a sudden desire to breathe some free air. I will seek you out later, after I find a good physician. And good luck, sister.
Gonna have to edit that out. Where am I going?
Who goes? You think you're clever, do you? Anybody tries to come in here without Howl's say-so, we get to do what we like with them. I think we finally got a bit of entertainment here, lads.
Yeah.
Another battle.
get you a ladder so you can get off my back. Got it.
Something that's always going to shoot you at these games is that you switch over to someone else's abilities, but you have no idea what they are or what they do.
What now? out of here! That's an order! Was this supposed to be a lesson? Did my father think it funny to leave me for so long before sending you? Then my father didn't send you?
I am Oswin, son of Ban Sigurd, of the Dragon's Peak Banner. If you aren't one of our soldiers, pray
thank
tell
you for
me,
putting the black
who should I be thanking
right
for my
there.
Rescue? Then I have no question about why you would come, Warden. For it is your men who have suffered the most here. You have my heartfelt gratitude. And I assume the gratitude of the
and
entire
that
Dragon's
is one hell of
banner.
A neck scene.
If my father sent no one after me, I can only assume that he does not yet know the true colors of the snakes he is allied with. But if you talk to him, I'm certain he would offer you any reward you might ask. Then ask what you will. I care not. All I want to see is my father again, and let his Chirurgeon see to my hands. Now, please. I must try to get to him. I cannot see the last of this place too soon.
Kind of a Cenobite type thing going on here. Oh, hey. A side quest. Yeah!
They said to retreat. The horn sounded, and we turned, and then the
We rode, and they screamed and screamed.
I am going to have a fun time editing up this one. Cut out all the dicks. I mean... yeah, whatever.
The light. Mother, you brought the light.
Yep. Alright, what quest was that? Missing in action. Anyway, it is time to take a break, so...